Hello, this is Andrew Thake from Minds and Money TV. And today I'm joined by Deepak Damodar, who is CEO of Damodar Limitada. Delighted to go and meet you, Deepak.
Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to present my company to your viewers. And I wish them all a good day. And I wish them that the very best for the coming years. Which is looking positive after the COVID situation.
Sure is. Perhaps you can start off by telling our viewers a little bit about your mining company.
See, my grandfather, Mr. Damodar, started his life in Mozambique. And Goa was a part of a Portuguese colony. And he came to Goa and established in 1942. And fortunately, we got involved in a large way and he was a pioneer in iron ore mining in Goa. Mm-hmm. And in 2011, 2012, we were exporting about 3 million tons of iron ore from Goa to China and Europe. Ours is a family business, and we are established in the iron ore or mining industry since last 70 years. Mm-hmm. Due to mining regulations and various NGOs and various other difficulties, I returned back to Mozambique, to my grandfather's original country where he started his life, and was looking for mineral resources in Mozambique. That's how I have come back to Mozambique.
Okay.
This is a brief background.
Okay. And then... how have the last 12 months been for you and been for your company? It must presumably have been tough with COVID-19. How did you manage to cope with that?
You see, basically, Mozambique has been spared with COVID as much as limited COVID is there. Mm-hmm. And the population is very sparse and spread out. So there has not been really any major incidences of COVID except in the capital city of Maputo. So Okay. Basically... We restarted our iron ore mining in North Mozambique, mm-hmm. in Nampula province, from January. Mm-hmm. And now we are shipping iron ore from Nacala port to China because, mm-hmm. as you know, the market is positive now. Therefore, we have restarted our mining operations in North Mozambique and exporting, mm-hmm. iron ore, high-grade iron ore from Mozambique. And we are the pioneers and the first exporters of iron ore from Mozambique in 2014. Nobody has exported iron ore from Mozambique ever. Mm-hmm.
So in terms of, I mean, what kind of really interested me about your story and your background as an iron ore company, there aren't sort of too many other sort of iron ore sort of like mining companies out there, probably of like your size, that investors could potentially invest in. But if you were asked by an investor as to how you stand out from other iron ore mining companies, what would you say to them?
Basically, iron ore is not a very popular mineral in Mozambique. Popular in the sense that there are not many deposits of iron ore in Mozambique. There are a few, but they are not exploited, possibly because of the knowledge of iron ore is limited for the locals there, you know. Mm-hmm. So we, being experienced in iron ore for the last 60 years in Goa, went to Mozambique basically to search for iron ore. Mm-hmm. And we found two deposits. One was a small deposit, mm-hmm. of high-grade magnetite iron ore, which we wanted to preliminarily produce for high-density aggregate for undersea pipeline coating. That was the, mm-hmm. one of the requirements which we were trying to market. Mm-hmm. And thereafter, we have found another big iron ore deposit, which has got magnetite high-grade iron ore and is a 90 square kilometer area allotted to us by the government of Mozambique. Now, the exploration was delayed because of COVID, and we were not able to get aeromagnetic survey from South Africa. Mm-hmm. So there is now in the exploration stage. And this deposit is also linked with a river port terminal plan, which can, for an outlet of exporting iron ore from east coast of Mozambique to China, to India, to Middle East. So that is our basic objective in the iron ore field, mm-hmm. as of now.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In addition, we have other minerals. We have other variety of minerals. Can I explain now or?
Please do. Yes, please do. Yeah.
Yeah. So during the 2015 to 2021, because of the lull in the iron ore market, we were explored other minerals in Mozambique, and we got the necessary concessions and license, which we have explored and done exploration. Firstly, we have a proven deposit under Jork for graphite in North Mozambique. It is close to Pemba, but not affected because of the insurgency. It is not affected. It is far away from there. We have also a very large marble deposit of white marble to gray marble in various shades. And it is got about 309 million tons of marble deposit. Then we have another very big deposit of granite, which granite is a very big hill of 50 square kilometers. It is close to Tet in central Mozambique. So basically we have iron ore, marble, granite, graphite. These are the four minerals. And we have now obtained from the government of Mozambique 100 hectares land on a riverfront to make it possible to export our iron ore through a river port on the east coast of Mozambique.
It this sounds like what you're saying, that the Mozambique government have been tremendously supportive of what you've been doing. What would you say to investors who ask you about Mozambique as a mining jurisdiction?
See, firstly, Mozambique has been is a young democracy, as you know. It's a young democracy. And Mozambique has been basically a Portuguese colony. So most of the law of mining laws, and for that matter, other laws, are all almost same as Portuguese laws. And there is a good infrastructure of legal base or legal matters are properly put in place by the government, and the mining laws are very practical, and they're copied from Mozambique law, from Portuguese law. So by legality, the mines, the mining law is very favorable. The environment is practically taken care of, well done. And the government is practically there to solve your environment problems, or, you know, cooperate in every way possible. The difficulties in Mozambique generally, or the challenge in Mozambique generally, is the logistics, where the roads or highways or railways are not were not in place. But in the last 5 years, there has been a tremendous change in the logistics. A lot of highways have come up. The railways have expanded. Vale has expanded their railway system. And therefore, now Mozambique is a very attractive destination for minerals. And we are sure the government of Mozambique wants to earn a lot of foreign exchange for their country, besides the natural gas which they have discovered recently. So I see a very bright future for Mozambique to be a very rich country in minerals and exports.
So it seems you have great mineral deposits, you have a great management team, you're in a great mining jurisdiction. Where do you want to be as a business in 1 year's time?
See, basically, we are a family business. We have limited resources. We have limited manpower or professionalism. We are basically a family business. So I am looking for a senior partner. I could say a senior partner, investor, or whatever you may call, or a mining company. We have a variety of these mines, maybe from marble, granite, iron ore, graphite. We are looking for good partners, reliable partners, like-minded partners for a joint venture and investment, as well as involvement in the mining and export of our projects, which are now well explored and are well logistically connected as of today. Because we have got highways now in place, we have got the railways in place, we are already exporting iron ore from Mozambique. So we can say that over a period of not 1 year, but over a period of 3 years, a lot of the minerals will be exported from Mozambique. We intend to export after 2 to 3 years.
Well, I mean, I think that would be really appealing to a lot of our investors who are listening in, because, you know, a family-owned business by its very nature is invested in its business, which really makes you stand out from the rest of the crowd. And I do definitely wish you all the best. I'm sure it's going to be a very, very successful year for Damodar Limitada. That was Deepak Damodar, CEO of Damodar Limitada, speaking to Andrew Thaik from Minds and Money TV. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Thank you.